Come on, we're just going to obey God this morning. Amen. We're just going to obey God this morning. Turn your Bibles to the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, verse 23. We're starting a new series this morning called The Influencers. How many know you got influencers in your life? Come on. How many know you got influencers in your life? This morning, I'm trying to influence you in a good way to tell you to work on your exercises, get your body in health. Amen. Trying to influence you in a good way because our health is important to us. But we have influencers in our lives, and we're going to talk about influences. We're not going to, listen, I got 9 pages of notes. I'm not even going to attempt to try to go through all 9 today. Amen. But we're going to obey the Holy Ghost. Amen. Now, if the Holy Ghost says, you just keep on going, we're going to go through all 9 pages, and plus he's going to add 9 more, then we're just going to obey God. Amen. Because you ain't got nothing else better to do on a Sunday. Hello? Amen. Some of y'all want to argue with me, don't you? I said, you ain't got nothing else better to do on a Sunday. This is the Lord's day. Come on. You ain't got nothing else on your schedule, and if you do, shame on you. Come on. Because this is the Lord's day. Hallelujah. Listen, I'm looking forward to that day when the council goes back there and locks the door of the church and don't let the preacher out. Come on. Because you don't want to stop having church. I'm looking forward to that day. Amen. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. Keep thou heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Father, I thank you this morning. Father, I thank you for the Holy Spirit in the church today. I thank you for ministering to the needs of the people before we ever had an opportunity to preach. God, I thank you, Lord, for just showing yourself to be alive and well and still sitting on the throne. Praise God. Father, I ask you to hold your servant, God. Hold me in your hand, God. Hide me behind the cross. Let your anointed flow through me into the hearts and the ears of the people today. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And everybody said, amen. Amen. To keep your heart. When we're talking about the word heart, we're talking about your soul. Amen. We're not talking about that flesh organ that's pumping blood. We're talking about your soul. All through the scriptures, when you see the word heart in the Bible, it's talking about your soul. So keep your soul with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Go with me to the book of Matthew, the 12th chapter, looking at the 34th verse. Matthew chapter 12, if you don't have your Bibles with you, you should be able to see it on the screen there. Matthew chapter 12, verse 34. For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Out of the abundance of the soul, the mouth speaks. A good man out of good treasures of his heart bringeth forth good things, and an evil man out of the evil treasures bringeth forth evil things. And there's verse 34. For by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned. In verse 37, where it's talking about by our words we'll be justified and by our words we'll be condemned, this is a reflection of your spiritual condition. Your spiritual condition of your heart. Of your soul. You know, we talked about health fitness. We've been talking about fasting on Wednesday nights, and we talked about the health benefits of actually going through a fast and what the doctors are telling us that a fast will actually do for your body physically. And we talked about the spiritual benefits that also go along with a fast. But how many of you realize that not only do we have physical fitness, but we have spiritual fitness? Hello? Come on. And we have mental fitness. And all three of those fitnesses are tied together. I assure you, your physical health will affect your mental thinking. Amen? Your physical health will affect your spiritual strength. Come on, church. How many of y'all have been there? Amen. You've been so sick in your body. You've been so much pain that you just could not have a spiritual thought in you. Amen. You just did not feel like getting out of bed. You didn't feel like going to church. You didn't feel like going to work because you're in such physical need. Amen. So your physical needs will affect your spiritual needs and your mental needs. Everything is tied together. But look at what the Lord says in Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. For keep your soul, keep thy soul with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Amen. So we're going to talk today about influence. The definition of influence is the capacity to have an effect on a character development or a behavior of someone or something, or to the effect itself. So the influence is you're having an effect when you have influences in your life. And many of us, all of us in this room, have influencers in our life. Amen. Your pastor's an influencer in your life. I'm trying to influence you to walk the narrow path with God. I'm trying to influence you to give your heart to Jesus Christ. I'm trying to influence you to stay on the narrow path so you can go to heaven. Amen. I'm trying to influence you to get in God's Word so you can live a victorious life. Amen. I'm trying to influence you through the Word of God and through the preaching and through the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is an influencer. Jesus Christ is an influencer. We're all trying to influence you to an abundant life. Amen. Jesus said the devil come to steal, kill, and destroy. Oh, but I come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. But I'm going to tell you, if you're not going to do what Jesus says, you'll never see the abundant life. If you never obey the scriptures, you'll never see the abundant life. Amen. Amen. Influencers are people or spirits that have an effect on your character or your behavior. A salesperson at a store is an influencer. Hello. One thing I cannot stand is to go to a car lot. First of all, I don't take my wife because they will pass me and start talking to her. I'm just telling you the truth. That's what they do. They will pass me and start talking to her, thinking that she has the purse strings and that she can influence me, until they find out how stubborn I am. Come on. And then they stop talking to her because they realize they ain't getting nowhere in the sale. Amen. Praise the Lord. Just the other day, we went to go buy a mattress. And of course, the salesperson is trying to influence us to get the highest quality, the most expensive. Hello. And I said, no, I'm just looking for one for our extra bedroom. Our grandchildren are going to be sleeping on it. I don't need all that cushion and softness. I just need a mattress, praise God. I don't need all the perks that come with all those things. Nobody's going to be sleeping on it every night. Only every now and then are we going to be using it. Amen. And they kept on, they kept on, they kept on, until they realized they were up against a brick wall because I wasn't moving. Amen. But a salesperson is an influencer that talks you in to buying a product. Amen. So you can see you have a lot of influences in your life. Today, influencers is a job career. It's a job career on the internet and working through YouTube. These people get paid big money to get you to watch their YouTube channels and as they advertise their products for you to buy. I saw my little granddaughter, my little Charlotte, she came over to the house and she wanted to watch YouTube videos. I mean, how many of y'all got grandkids out there who want to watch YouTube videos? Amen? It seems like that's all they want to do now. But she was watching this little YouTube video and we put it up on the TV screen and we're all watching it together. I mean, we watch Bluey and all those other, y'all know who Bluey is? Amen. Come on. The problem is Angel and I are starting to watch Bluey without the granddaughter now. There may be a problem here, praise the Lord. But we was watching with her and she was watching this other little girl play on YouTube. And I'm sitting in my chair scratching my head saying something ain't right. Amen. Because when I was a little boy, I didn't watch nobody play. I went and did the playing. Come on. You had to beat me to get me in the house. Come on. Because as soon as it was daylight, I wanted to go outside. Amen. My Lord, has the generations changed today? But she was watching this little girl about her own age, and she's just playing with these toys. And my granddaughter is tuned in. I mean, eyes wide open. She's looking like, and I'm watching her, and I'm watching them like, what are we doing? Then I begin to realize toy companies are sending this little girl toys to try out, and she's playing with their toys. Amen. Because the doorbell rang, and the delivery man showed up, and guess what was in the box? More toys. It was a huge commercial is what it was. It was a YouTube commercial on buying toys. They get your granddaughter or your grandson or your grandkids hooked on the YouTube and watching them play with the toys. And then they want the same toy. Nana, I want that toy. Papa, I want that toy. This is how it begins. Amen. Back in my day, we just saw a little toy commercial in between Bugs Bunny and Roadrunner. Amen. Things have changed again. Amen. And not only that, but my other little grandson, he watches YouTube videos of other people playing video games. My Lord, what are we coming to? I mean, so he's not even playing the video game. My grandson is just watching this other guy play the video game. And it's hyped up. I mean, they're hollering, they're shouting. It's so much noise, we have to tell them to turn it down because it's just too much racket. And he's telling you how to beat the game. So they're watching it to show how to beat the game. The problem with these games today, come on, you better watch your bank account because they're starting to charge money for an extra tool or an extra thing so they can get to the next level. How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? Amen. You know what I'm talking about? Make sure your credit card's not tied into your tablet because your child will run your credit card up. Amen. So this is what's happened. These people are called influencers. This is an entire business today. Influencers. So influencers are out there. It's a big money-making project is what it is. Amen. And today, I'm trying to influence you to get your health together. Amen. Many of you come to say, I need prayer for healing. Lord, pray for me. I'm going through this. Lord, pray for me. I need healing in my body. But when the doctor says, well, I'm going to give you this prescription, but if you need to exercise too, and they give you a whole list of things to do, we want to throw those things out and not exercise. And we got to fall back on what Meemaw says. Amen. God's only going to help you do. Come on, y'all, finish it with me. God's only going to help you do what you can't do yourself. Amen. Amen. So these things are important. Keep your heart with all diligence. We must be very careful what we allow to influence us. Influencers will affect how you think, what you think about, and when you think about them. Hello? That's what they do. They influence your thinking. When you think, what you think, and how you think about it. So influencers have a big, big influence in our life. In the beginning, Satan goes into the Garden of Eden and he starts talking to Eve to turn her thinking about what God told her and Adam. How many of y'all know that story? Genesis chapter 1. Amen. Satan was an influencer and he influenced her to sin. Did he not? He talked her into it. Isn't that what temptation is? Temptation is an influencer. It talks you into sin. And that's what Satan did in the Garden of Eden. Sin came upon mankind because they did not guard their hearts. They did not guard their soul. They just listened to anything the old devil had to say. How many of you realize that's dangerous? You cannot allow the devil just to tell you anything he wants to say. You cannot allow people just to tell you anything they want to say. You need to guard your heart, guard your soul, and what you are receiving as information. Because you're getting bad information sometimes. Amen. When President Trump came into the office, we all began to learn a new thing. It was called fake news. Amen. And all of us looked and said, oh, conspiracy theory people, what's wrong with y'all? It can't be fake news. I've been watching the news all my life. I believe everything they tell me. Amen. Come on, somebody. But how many of you realize now that we all understand what fake news is? Amen. They're influencers. They're influencers. So in Proverbs chapter 23 and verse 7, it says, as a man thinketh in his heart, again soul, so is he. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. As he thinks in his soul, so he becomes. Whatever you are thinking about the most in your life will begin to have an effect on you. Come on. Amen. It will begin to have an effect on you. It will begin to affect your body. It will begin to affect your mind. What you're thinking about the most will begin to have an effect. You've got to guard your thoughts. You've got to take captive your thoughts and say, I bind these evil thoughts. I bind these thoughts. Jesus gave us the power of binding and loosing. He said, whatever you bind on earth, I'll bind in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth, I'll loose in heaven. So it's called the power of binding and loosing. You are in control of what you think. Amen. Angel, what's that little saying you've been teaching the teenagers back here in the back? Y'all help me out. You got it right there. Your mind is your mind. Amen? The devil has no place in your mind that you don't give him. You give it to him. But as a man thinketh in his heart, thinketh in his soul, so he becomes. Let that sink in for a while. Satan and other influencers know that if they can change how you think about things, they can take you to the action on what you're thinking about. Let me say that again for everybody who's not in church this morning. Satan and the influencers know that if they can get you to think about some things, they can get you to take action on what you're thinking about. Action always starts with a thought first. You're going to think about it before you take the action. Amen? And this is why. The news media, as we all know, is a big influencer in our lives. They tell us what to think, when to think, certain ways to think. They are affecting our views about politics. Amen? They are affecting our views about evolution or creation. Amen? I hope I don't have any evolutioners in the house of the Lord this morning. But where does that come from? Influencers. Amen. These influencers are influencing our religious views, our worldly views, and our political views. Amen. This is why the whole world has been taken captive by all the governments of where we are today, because of all these views that they're putting upon us. So we got to be careful of what we're listening to. Hitler said, "He who controls the media controls the world." That makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? Amen? You want to be in charge, and first thing you got to do is be in charge of the information flow. That's what you got to do. You got to be in charge of the information flow. I saw an interview of a woman in Austria, and one of the first things that Hitler did is he put down the radio stations, he put down the news media, and they were only allowed to give the news that he allowed to be given. In other words, it'd be proofread. It had to go through Hitler first before it went out to the people. Because he wanted to control the people, wanted to control how they thought and what they were thinking about and when they were thinking about it. It was all control. So he who controls the media does control the world. And news reports are now professional influencers. How many of y'all remember the good old days? Walter Cronkite and all the good ones. They never gave us their opinion. They just told the news. Amen. I miss those days. Because they would just be standing in front of something and say, "I'm out here, the building's on fire, and these people are shooting one another." And well, back to you, Jan. You know, that was it. But now the building's on fire. Oh, but they're peaceful protesting. Oh, somebody got shot, but you know, they were playing with a gun themselves. I mean, so it goes on and on. Their influence of their personal opinions are starting to influence the way America thinks. We need to get back to the good old days where they just told the facts of the way things are and let us make our own decisions on what we think about them. Amen? Amen. Amen. I've learned that in today's time, it's actually faster to watch regular people on YouTube give the news than it is to watch the world news. Amen. We learned about the protests in Canada with the truckers 2 weeks before it ever hit the world news. 2 weeks, because I went to the news, I started watching it just to see when they were going to report it. 2 weeks before they reported on the truck drivers in Ottawa, Canada, it was all over YouTube. We learned about it through YouTube. Why is that? Because they did not want you to know. They're afraid of the truckers in the United States getting together doing the same thing. And they are. Today, praise God. They are today, of all days, the truckers in the United States are going to do something. Amen. How many of y'all want our freedoms back? Amen. Amen. Listen, we grew up in an America of freedom. It's time to get our freedom back, praise the Lord. So say a prayer for the truckers in Canada and the United States and around the world that God will protect them. Amen. And influence them in a good way. Amen. 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 Revelation chapter 12 in verse 4, it tells us that Satan took a third of the angels with him when he fell from heaven. Revelation chapter 12 and verse 4, I don't think we have it on the screens, I didn't give it. But it tells us that a third of the angels went and fell with Lucifer when he fell out of heaven. Revelation chapter 12, verse 9 gives us the details a little bit. It says, "And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil, and Satan, which deceived the whole world. He was cast out into the earth." Notice it says into the earth, not on the earth. Notice that. "Into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him." His angels were cast out with him. Listen, Satan influenced one third of the angels in heaven to sin against God and start a war in heaven to try to take over the kingdom of heaven. So Satan is the ultimate influencer of all. If he can talk angels out of heaven, I assure you, he can talk people into hell. Amen? Amen. He can talk them into hell. So he talked these angels to leave their state of where they were in the holiness and to sin against God in rebellion and the war that took place in heaven, and they were kicked out of heaven and into the earth. The scriptures call Satan the deceiver, which is what the evil influencer does. Deceives you into believing his lies so that he can get you to do what he wants you to do. Well, we got to guard our hearts, church. We need to guard our hearts that we be not deceived to believe the devil's lies. Guard your hearts. Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 17 says, tells us to put on the helmet of salvation. Have you ever wondered why? Why does the book of Ephesians tell us right there in chapter 6 to put on the helmet of salvation? Amen. The helmet of salvation. We've learned a couple of weeks back that the VMAT2 gene, or the God gene as science puts it, is in the brain and it affects your beliefs in God and your beliefs in spiritual things. And it's amazing that we know that our soul is our mind. Our mind is our soul. It's made up of our soul. And so this helmet of salvation is to protect your soul. It's to protect your mind against the enemy's attacks. Listen, the greatest battlefield in all of history is only about 6 inches. Hello? Come on. Right here. Between ear to ear. This is where your battlefield takes place. This is where the real war is. What are you allowing in? What are you allowing inside of you? Because whatever it is you're allowing in is affecting you. It's affecting how you think. Amen. It's affecting how you think. It's affecting how you talk. It's affecting how you walk. It's affecting your actions. Amen. So put on the helmet of salvation to protect your mind, which holds your thinking and what you think about. Remember the scripture, "As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he." The first attack Satan does after you made a decision to give your heart to Jesus, come on, y'all help me out. The first attack, you know, the first attack the devil does to you after you made a decision for Christ, "I'm going to give my heart to Jesus, I'm going to invite him to come into my life." The first attack the devil does is he begins to tell you, "You didn't get nothing. You know you're not saved. You feel the same as you felt before. You still think the same as you. I heard you cuss the other day." Y'all know the devil. Come on. Come on. And he will attack your belief in getting saved. He will attack your belief in giving your heart to the Lord. It's the first attack to get you to doubt God's word, to get you to doubt your experience of salvation in itself. Amen. How many of you learned you got to push through that and say, "No, Mr. Devil, I believe the word of God. I believe the word of God. If I confess my sins, he is faithful and he is just to forgive me of all my sins and cleanse me from unrighteousness." Amen. You see, it ain't about how you feel. It's about what the word says about you. Amen. I'm telling you, church, if you go by your feelings, you're in big, big trouble. And we got generations coming up that walk by their feelings instead of walking by common sense. Amen. Amen? Let me say that again for everybody that fell asleep. I said we got generations of people that walk by feelings instead of common sense. Amen. And don't walk by the word of God. So we got to learn to attack these thoughts that come to us. He would tell you that you're not saved. You need to tell him that you are. Amen. Then he will try to tell you other things in the Bible are not true or have been done away with. like the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Oh, you know people don't talk in tongues no more. You know that was done away with the apostles. That's funny. I heard some tongue-talking women up here just a few minutes ago. Hello? Did anybody else hear some tongue-talking women up here praying just a few minutes ago? Oh, but that's been done away with, brother. Really? Really? Show me that scripture in verse. Because I've never found it. Amen? I've never found it. But yet we experience the baptism of the Holy Ghost today, don't we? Amen. But the devil will tell you that. He'll tell you that healing has been done away with. God don't heal anybody anymore. You're just going to have to suffer with what you got. I'm sorry, brother and sister, but I've never found that scripture either. By his stripes, I am healed, is what Isaiah says. 1 Peter 2 and 24 says, and by his stripes ye were, W-E-R-E, were, past tense, healed. Nowhere in the scripture does it say that Jesus stopped healing. Amen? How many, raise your hand if God has ever healed your body. Come on. So you know that's a lie, right? Amen? But these are the first things that the devil attacks when he attacks your mind and he tries to tell you these things. He attacks your mind and tell you these things are not true. But they are true. Amen? It is believed by many theologians that Lucifer was the highest archangel over music and over worship to God in heaven until he decided he wanted to be worshipped. So that Satan, his name was Lucifer at the time, he was the worship leader of all of heaven. He was the one that orchestrated the worship to God. Until one day he decided that he wanted to receive the worship instead of giving it to God. And this is when iniquity was found in him. This is when the sin was found in him, is when he began to think these things. Amen. Well, come on, just say praise the Lord. Come on, praise the Lord. That's all right, brothers. Happened to us all at least once. Amen. But the devil was over music. It's not hard to believe that he still has a huge influence over music today. Amen. He has a huge influence over music. Ezekiel chapter 28 and 14 and Isaiah chapter 14 through 12 through 15 verse tells us about Lucifer being over the music and how he had these instruments. So since he was the great musician before the fall in heaven, it's not hard for us to see his influence today in music. Satan uses music to influence people to think a certain way, dress a certain way, and even act a certain way. You can tell what kind of music people listen to just by looking at how they dress. Come on. Shake your head yes. You know I'm telling the truth this morning. Amen. You can tell what music people listen to just based on how they dress. You can. Amen. People who listen to a lot of rock and roll, they'll wear the t-shirts, you know, the ones that got the tongue hanging out, you know what I'm talking about. Amen. They'll wear that one. They'll wear their jeans. Amen. And they have a tendency of like to do a lot of drinking and a lot of drugging. Have you noticed that? Amen. Country music listeners are usually a very depressed people. Hello, I know I'm stepping on somebody's toe this morning, but it's all right. Country music is depressing. Amen. Most of the songs are written about heartbreak and hard times. Amen. You know, your wife left you, your truck broke down, and your dog did not return from the hunting trip. Come on, somebody. And country music has a tendency of staying in those lines and it brings depression with it. Amen, it does. It brings depression with it. What about rap music? Oh, you can always tell when somebody loves rap music. You know, the hat turns sideways, the pants get baggy. Hello, somebody. You can start seeing their underwear. Amen. Come on. They start walking a certain way. You know what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. You can always tell. Why does that kind of music have effect? All the music has an effect on somebody in some way. Why? Because their spirits have been assigned to those music. There are spirits that are influencing people in that music realm to act a certain way, dress a certain way, think a certain way, talk a certain way. Hello? Hello? All you got to do is open your eyes and ears and you can see it. Listen, you don't need the Holy Spirit to give you discernment to see that. It's there. It's there. How many of y'all remember Rocky? Y'all remember Rocky? Come on. Remember Rocky? Hey, y'all need to get some Rocky music playing. I can pump a lot of iron with Rocky playing, I'm telling you. Amen. I can remember when I was in the Army, and they wanted to pump us up because we're getting ready to go on a force road march, or we're getting ready to run about 5 miles wide open, you know, with rucksacks and all that stuff. And I can remember seeing the checkered flag. I said, okay, I know I'm at the end. And the closer I got to the end, I could hear the Rocky theme. You know what happened on the inside of me? My heart started beating better. Amen. And my feet started getting faster, praise God, because I could hear Rocky, praise God. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Amen. I mean, you can't watch a Rocky movie without having an itch to get into a ring and box it out with somebody, you know? There's something about the Rocky music that pumps you up. Amen. Music has an effect on people. Praise the Lord. All right, now, let's see if we can't turn these cell phones off. Praise the Lord. So Rocky music has an effect on people. It pumps them up. It's hype music. I learned recently when we were at youth camp, Angel and I were at youth camp with the kids. You guys probably remember, those are with us, you two remember, at youth camp, there was people that would get on stage and they were hype people. They would jump around, boy, the music was bouncing and they were jumping around and they had the crowd going and there was a bunch of hype. And that's all it was hype. It wasn't no Jesus, it wasn't no nothing really. It was just a bunch of hype. I mean, people were jumping around and all, and they were hype. I learned after that a lot of churches hire these hype people to get the crowds hyped up before the preacher preaches. Amen. Some of y'all keep sitting down on me, I'm going to go find me one. Amen. Get somebody hyped up around here. Get somebody fired up for Jesus. That's their job. And that's what the devil does. He hypes people up with the wrong type of message. My point is, what music you listen to has an effect on you. It has an effect on how you think. It has an effect on what you say and what you do. And the reason music influences people so much is because there are certain spirits that have been assigned to the music to influence you. Demons influence people through music that they listen to. Music can be used to keep people in bondage. Like I was talking about country music being depressing. We must wake up to what is happening and see it through the spiritual eyes. As pastor, I don't listen to worldly music. I can't afford to. You see, as pastor, I need to make sure I'm flowing in the anointing all the time, because at any given moment, somebody's going to need me to pray for them. Amen? I need the anointing. I need to stay connected to God. I need to stay spiritually connected to God at all times, so I cannot allow influencers in my life to influence me. I've had some people that would send me a video prophecy, and it would come, and I'd say, I'm going to have to wait till after Sunday to watch it, or maybe watch it Sunday night after I'm done preaching, because I don't want influence upon my preaching. Amen. And so there's music that I don't listen to. Listen, I grew up with the long hair and the tight shirts and the tight jeans, amen, and the heavy metal music. The heavier the metal music was, the better I liked it. And the louder it was, the better I liked it. I had the Pioneer speakers in the back of my 78 Mustang, and they would blast you out of the car. Amen. That's what I grew up in. I don't listen to that stuff anymore, because it had an influence on my life. It's something about rock and roll that makes my right foot real heavy on that gas pedal. I don't know why, but the louder it plays, the faster I want to drive. It's an influence. I don't listen to country music anymore, because country music makes me want to kick my dog, come on, burn my truck down, and go find Jack Daniels. So I don't listen to country music no more. It has an influence. The only music I listen to is praise and worship music. We have praise and worship music going in our house most of the time, running around the clock 24/7, because I need the connection with God. I need to stay connected to God for the anointing to flow, and you need me to stay connected to God so the anointing will flow. Amen? Amen. Amen. I want to encourage everybody who is in music to be very careful what you're listening to. Get away from the worldly effects of music and go to God's music. Amen. It has an effect. It has an effect. Amen. The more from Satan you hear, more fear will be inside of you. Romans chapter 10, verse 17 is my last scripture. It says, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. If you want more faith, then you must hear more about God's word. If you want more faith, you must hear more about God's word. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. The word of God is an influencer. It should have an influence in our lives. So if the word of God, the more you hear the word of God and it has an influence in your life, and faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God, let's just flip this around. The opposite of faith is fear. And the more you hear from Satan, the more fear is going to be on the inside of you. Because fear comes by hearing and hearing by the words of Satan. You see how I just flipped that around? It's the gospel truth. We got to be careful what we listen to. I used to listen to a lot of talk radio when I was working in the shop. I began to get angrier and angrier as I listened to talk radio. And finally, after a while, I had to turn it off. I said, I can't listen no more because I'm getting angrier and angrier about politics and everything else. Why? Because all of this has an effect on our spirit person. Has an effect. Amen. Let's all stand to our feet this morning. Father, we thank you this morning, God. We thank you this morning for your spirit in our church, God. We thank you, Lord, for opening our eyes to seeing the influencers that are in our lives today. Father, I pray for everybody that's in the sound of my voice this morning, God, that you would bring correction to their lives as we bind and rebuke the influencers that are influencing us in bad ways. That we bind and rebuke the influencers that have got our thoughts going down the wrong path. Lord, I ask you right now to deal with the hearts of your people. God, things that they need to repent of, I ask you to bring it to them right now. Bring sin up that they need to repent of and push out the sin and push out the influences in their lives right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you, Lord, as we release the angels of heaven into our lives today, as we bind and rebuke the evil influencers of our lives, no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper, because the Holy Scripture tells us that this is an inheritance of the kingdom of God, that no weapon formed against us will prosper. In the name of Jesus, you spiritual influencers, we bind you and rebuke you, and we break the strongholds over you right now. In the name of Jesus. Father, I pray that you will draw your people closer to you through the process called sanctification. The process of sanctification this morning, God. Lord, as we draw closer to you today, in the name of the Most High God, we pray. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And amen. And we've already prayed for some this morning. But I want to encourage you, if you still need prayer, you're here and you still need prayer, come on up. We'll be glad to pray with you. Let me do one more thing. Everybody close your eyes. I wonder if there'd be anybody here this morning. I wonder if there'd be anybody here that does not know Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. If you're here this morning and you don't know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, let me tell you, today is the day of salvation. Don't wait any longer. Or maybe you're here and you say, well, I used to walk with the Lord and now I haven't felt Him in a long time. I just don't feel like I'm close to the Lord anymore. Maybe that's you this morning. I'm going to ask you just to join me in prayer this morning. Repeat after me, if you will. Say, Lord Jesus. Come on, let me hear the voices. Lord Jesus. I repent of my sins. Lord Jesus, I'm sorry. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Come into my soul. Give me the rebirth experience. I give my soul to you, Lord. I want to be your child. I want heaven to be my home. I confess you, Lord. I confess you as my Savior. I confess you as my King. I confess you as my God, both now and forever. I rebuke sin out of my life. I rebuke spirits out of my life. And everything that separates me from God. In the name of the Most High God. In the name of Yeshua. The Hebrew name of Jesus. Amen.
Hello everyone, I'm Angel Hendrix. I'm Pastor C.J. Hendrix's wife. We pastor here at the Bowdon Church of God in Bowdon, Georgia. And we thank you for tuning into our YouTube channel and watching the videos that we have been putting out. We would also like to invite you to come and be a part of our services live. If you don't have a church and you live in the East Alabama and West Georgia area, you are more than welcome to come. Our address is 1030 West College Street, Bowdon, Georgia, 30108. And if you need to get in contact with us, our phone number is 770-940-4813. And we would like to share with you our heart today, and it is about your salvation. If you do not know the Lord as your personal Lord and Savior, we would like to share a small prayer with you today that will help you to bring Him into your heart and into your life so that He may change your world. Now, if you'll just close your eyes and or bow your heads and repeat after me this prayer, I will lead you to the Lord right now. Father God, we just thank you for the many viewers that are watching today, God. We thank you for their hearts, God, and we ask you to help them to come into your kingdom. So repeat after me now. Father God, I thank you for freeing my soul of my sins. I thank you for forgiving my sins. I thank you that you have loved me enough that Jesus died on the cross and rose on that third day to give me salvation. I thank you, Father, and I worship you in spirit and in truth, and I give you my life today. I want you to come into my heart and into my home. I want you to be a part of my life from this day forward. I give you all the honor, the praise, and the glory, for in Jesus' name, amen. Now, if you said that prayer today, you find you a good Bible-based church. If it's our church, great. If it's a church near you, that's fine too. Make sure they teach you the Word of God from the Bible. And as you grow in God, God will grow in you. Allow Him to become a part of your life so that you may share this message with others. And again, thank you for watching our YouTube channel. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact us. You can also visit our website at bowdoncog.org. And I will say goodbye now and see you later.